Welcome to the presentation Synergy API Solutions by MF Software. My name is Sebastian Mönnich. I have studied mechanical engineering at the Technical University of Darmstadt, have then worked as a research assistant at the German Institute for Polymers and the Fraunhofer LBF. I finished my PhD in 2015 and I'm working at PG and MF Software since 3 years now. I am the team leader of the Structural Mechanics Department and responsible for the Moldflow API programming team. Today, I would like to present three Moldflow API solutions that aim to make everyday challenges of engineers and designers easier to accomplish and to support in making better products with a focus on development time and costs. The first product I would like to show you is the Tolerance tool, which enables an easy development accompanying analysis of dimensions and tolerances of molded parts, which are analyzed with Moldflow. The second product is the report generator, which supports the creation of reports and shifts the sometimes time-consuming loading of results into the night by batch processing, so that no resources are tied up during the day. And with Gate & Go, we are introducing a tool that enables designers to check their components as early as the design phase and thus to comply with the economic and technical criteria of their company. The presentation of the Tolerance tool is divided into an overview of the usual steps of the workflow, a closer look at several steps of the workflow, a summary of the main features, and a conclusion. The workflow starts with the definition of critical measurements and tolerances of the part to be analyzed, which can be done by either importing an Excel list, PLM data from your CAD environment, or directly in the Tolerance tool. Then you select the Moldflow study that should be analyzed and automatically create notes at the measurement points. After the part is meshed, you can employ Moldflow or the Tolerance tool to add node-based measurements. When the warp edge simulation is finished, you use the Tolerance tool to evaluate all your predefined measurements with one click and display the results in an OK, not OK list. If you wish, you can also compare different studies, which for example, different process settings, and compare the influence on the resulting warp edge by the use of an overview table.
As I said, the first step is to generate measurement reports. This can be done by importing the measurement data from Excel. Filling out predefined lists can already be done by the designer or by the project team. To create a measurement, a unique name and the necessary coordinates for the measurement are necessary. For example, you have the unique name distance 1, the measurement principle is distance, and you need two coordinates in X, Y, and Z direction. For a position, unique name position 1, measurement principle position, you only need one coordinate. For an angle, angle 1 in this example, you need three coordinates. This information will then be imported into the Tolerance tool. An advantage of using tables for critical dimensions is that this information can be viewed and discussed by all members of a project group and not only the designer who is actually creating the CAD data. For the designer, we are currently working on interfaces to the most common CAD tools. This will enable the designer to either export tables for the use in the Tolerance tool and discussion, or directly give the information to the Tolerance tool. This also has the big advantage that parametric designs and the change of dimensions and tolerances will be very easily to handle. We are currently working on interfaces to Inventor, CATIA, Siemens NX, and ProE. Besides the Excel import function, it is also possible to create measurement reports directly in the graphical user interface of the Tolerance tool. Like in the Excel import, you need to give the measurement a unique name, select the type of measurement via this drop-down menu. In this example, it is a distance. You enter the coordinates for point 1 and point 2, give the nominal dimension and the allowed tolerances. By clicking Create Measurement, the measurement is added to the list. If all predefined measurements are made, the next step is the selection of the Moldflow project to be analyzed. All studies available in the project are displayed in the drop-down menu and can be selected for analysis. In the animation that we're about to see, you can see what will happen if we click the Update Moldflow button. Injection locations are created at the previously entered coordinates, which are then integrated during the actual meshing process of the component and thus available for taking measurements. This is necessary to ensure that nodes are created at the coordinates where measurements will be taken. Any injection location that is not in the list of measurements and therefore a real injection location will of course be kept for the following analysis. After the meshing process, all injection locations created for measurements will be automatically removed, leaving only the nodes on which we will take our measurement. From this point onward, it is still possible to add measurements, but they now must be node-based. If the Moldflow user wishes to work with an already meshed study or add further measurements on a node basis, this is also possible. On the second tab of the tolerance tool, measurement reports can be generated on a node basis. It is again necessary to give a unique name, the type of measurement from the drop-down menu, the nominal dimensions and tolerances. Unlike the coordinate-based definition, the tolerance tool interacts directly with the Moldflow Synergy in this step. For the selection of nodes, the Synergy's own tools, such as Select Nodes on Edge or Select Nodes on Surface, are used. For this roundness example, we selected the nodes on this edge. The transfer of the nodes and thus the completion of the measurement is done via the button Get Selection from Moldflow and Create Measurement. The measurement is then again created in the list of measurements. This feature was integrated because it is much simpler to select nodes on a cylindric edge than to enter several coordinates which will be used to calculate, for example, a roundness. If the shrinkage and warpage results are available in the Moldflow Synergy after a successful simulation, the results of the analysis in the tolerance tool can be easily accessed by simply clicking the Load Results button. A table shows the names of the individual measurements, the nominal dimensions, the tolerance field, the results calculated from the Moldflow simulation, and the deviation from the tolerance field. By the colored representation of the individual lines, it can be recognized immediately whether the respective measurement is within or outside the given tolerance field. If the Moldflow specialist is analyzing the influence of process settings on the resulting warpage, it is also possible to view variant calculations in the tolerance tool. In addition to the detailed presentation shown before, it is possible to quickly evaluate whether, for example, changing process parameters has led to an improvement with regard to the specified tolerances. Now let me just sum up the most important features of the tolerance tool. In general, the tolerance tool allows the quick and easy analysis of functional dimensions, e.g. those defined by the designer. The analysis possibilities include the displacement of absolute positions, distances, length, angles, straightness, roundness, parallelism, cylindricity, flatness, and coaxiality. It is possible to fix the part via toll tool in the same way as it might be fixed in a gouge after production. In order to analyze the influence of process settings, a quick comparison of different simulation stages or process variance is possible. The usual features such as saving and loading current work statuses are a matter of course. In summary, it can be said that with the tolerance tool, a simple and time-saving creation of reusable measurement reports and the verification of many measurements is possible in a few seconds. The reusability of measurement reports for small geometric changes can save further time in processing. The comparison of variance is particularly helpful in the evaluation and the design of the process or the injection point. During development, special attention was paid to the fact that unlike standard metrology software, the focus is on the mold flow user. In contrast to standard metrology software, it takes only about 1 hour to create 50 dimensions, including tolerances with the tolerance tool. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Mr. Rainer Handel and his colleagues at Mahle Filtersysteme GmbH for their great cooperation in this project. Next, I will introduce you to the MF Software Report Generator, which supports you in the creation of mold flow reports. This part of the presentation is also divided in an overview of the necessary workflow to generate reports, a closer look at some steps, the main features, and a conclusion. The development of the report generator was mainly driven by the questions: how can reporting be made efficient? How can standards be introduced into a company? And how can a report nevertheless be as individual as every project? As efficiency is the big challenge in reporting, the workflow to generate a report with the report generator is fairly simple. It can consist of 4 steps, but even that is only necessary if you want to individualize everything. The workflow starts with the input of general project-related data, but the main part is the selection and layout of results and views that will in the finished report be one PowerPoint slide. And then the choice whether you want to create the report immediately or add it to a batch queue so it can be processed overnight. On the first page of the report generator, general project-related data is entered, and these are the project title, the project number, the project manager, and the company name. These settings are of course saved automatically so that for the next report, for example, only the project title needs to be changed. On the second page, the general layout of the report is defined. If you wish and keep it really simple, you can adjust your part to one standard view on this page and create the report. But you can also load views and layouts of old reports and apply it to the current project. For example, if you want to report on the same part that was just simulated with different process settings or another material. If you want to customize your report or even every single result, you can do that on the third step. On the Get Result page of the report generator, all results of the selected mold flow study are displayed. Each bar in the list will be a page of a PowerPoint presentation of the final report. It is possible to change the order of the slides by dragging and dropping them in order. It is also possible to add or remove results from the list. By clicking on the settings wheel, individual plots can then be individualized. If you want to individualize single plots, you can do that via the settings wheel. Over the settings wheel, you have the possibility to select from several standard views. You can also select what you want to display in the report, meaning manage the layers of the Synergy output. And you can choose whether you want to display the geometry or the live view of the current result from the Synergy. In this example, it is the fill time. You can set the time step you want to report on, and of course, leave a comment to the result. If you want to report on something that you cannot see in a standard view and have to provide an angle that you can set over the Synergy, you can do that as well. In this video, you see in the big frame the Synergy and in the small frame the report generator. Now you start to adjusting your view in the Synergy as you want to display the result in the report. You then click on the Get Picture from Mold Flow button in the report generator to display the result in the report generator as you set it in the Synergy. You can then do all the customizations you did with the standard views. In this example, we are trying to show you how you set a view from the bottom of the part, set the time step where we found the weld lines in the slide before, and give the comment that you are seeing the weld lines from the bottom of the part. In the last step, you decide whether you want to generate a report immediately or add it to a batch queue. This way, you have the possibility to prepare several reports during the day without being slowed down by loading times of results and to postpone the actual creation of the report into the night. Here you can see an active batch queue where some of the jobs are already completed, one job is in progress, and some jobs are pending. Now I would like to show you an excerpt of a report and the possibilities that the report generator offers. Here you see the presentation of material data and process parameters, different results with different views, as well as diagrams in which significant points are already marked. The most important features of the report generator are its complete customization regarding the layout of the report via PowerPoint master slides, an automatic display of all results per study, the individual customization of single results with nodes, views, and layers, and the transfer of finished reports to other Moldflow studies, which will save you a lot of time. Particularly noteworthy is the possibility to prepare reports only and to postpone the long loading times of results, especially for large models, into the night by batch processing. The challenges and questions that drove the development of the report generator can now be answered. How can reporting be made efficient? First, by the possibility to use report templates with defined views, time steps, etc. for studies where the geometry did not change, for example, if you changed the material or the process settings. And second, by the possibility to just prepare the reports and shift the actual creation of the report and therefore loading times of results, which may be long with large models, into the night. How can standards be introduced into a company? By the possibility to use a PowerPoint master template with the report generator. Your colors, positions of pictures, positions of notes and remarks, the logo and so on can be set to your corporate identity and then be used by all Moldflow users in the company. And how can a report nevertheless be as individual as every project? Through the possibility to adapt, if you want to, every single result to your needs. If you have done a few reports with the report generator, you will be able to save up to 90% of the time that is usually required to prepare a report. Finally, I would like to introduce a Synergy API product that especially supports designers in their work. Let me start with a couple of questions. How many percent of your new parts are checked by simulation? And how long is the waiting time for a designer to get a simulation slot in the simulation department? Maybe you think about these questions as we go along and see how Gate&Go can support you in giving satisfactory answers. The main goal of this tool is to generally increase the quality of your parts in technological and economic aspects by applying company criteria on the design. This is done through two main program parts of Gate&Go. The Gate&Go Assistant, which supports the designer, and the Gate&Go Expert, which enables the Moldflow department to define component groups for which the department also defines economic and technical criteria. The use of Gate&Go also enables you to monitor the skills of the designer and support him in a learning by doing kind of manner. The workflow is divided into two steps. The first step must be done only once per product or product group by the Moldflow specialist. They have to define criteria for the part that allow the automatic evaluation of simulation results, and these criteria consists of component sizes, materials, process settings, and boundary conditions for certain results. The designer's job is then only to define an injection point gate and launch the simulation. Go. As a result, the designer will get design instructions that help him to meet the company's criteria for that part that he is designing. As already mentioned, the first step is to set up criteria by the Moldflow department. These criteria are specific to a certain kind of part or group of parts. Examples might be housings for an electric appliance in different sizes, brackets of one kind in different sizes, and so on. The idea is to identify parts that, of course, don't have the exact same geometry, but can be categorized. For such a kind of product, the mold flow department defines a so-called product group. It is possible to define several sizes of the same product group. For each product group, the specialist department allows only those materials best suited for the job, which also helps to reduce the number of materials used in a company. The next step is to define process parameters for the product group with respect to the material. To ensure reasonable results from the mold flow simulation, meshing criteria can also be set. The most important part is the definition of evaluation criteria. This information is the know-how and experience of the mold flow department. This can be best explained by giving some examples. The mold flow departments know from experience that the filling of a certain kind of part usually takes between 0.3 and 0.6 seconds. They also know that the filling pressure must not exceed 500 bar. Simply by typing in the numbers the mold flow departments know by experience, they make all the knowledge available to the designer. And how the designer utilizes this knowledge, I will show by sharing the evolution of a part that has been analyzed by Gate & Go. In this picture, you can see the first design that the designer wants to be analyzed. The designer starts an analysis by assigning a project name, gives the path to the CAD data, and selects component specifications that have already been made by the specialist department. He then selects a material from the list that is appropriate for these kind of components and defines the gate position. By clicking Go, a mold flow simulation is set up, carried out, and analyzed in the background, fully automatically and based on the specifications of the mold flow department. This picture from the mold flow synergy is not shown to the designer. It is only used here in this presentation to show where he decided to put the injection location. As the result of an analysis, the designer receives the table shown on the right. Here he can see through the clear traffic light display whether there is potential for improvement in his design. The table shows different results. You can see the result of the own study and the specification of the so-called green area given by the mold flow department. These are the evaluation criteria. However, the most important information is a recommendation on how the corridor specified by the department can be achieved by design measures. In this case, the designer sees that he exceeds the maximum permitted filling time for this group of component. Due to the node injection point to decentralized, he starts a new analysis with the part injected in the middle. In the result of the second analysis, he sees that although the injection point is now central, the filling time is still exceeded. This could be an indication that the base wall is too thick. In addition, the result plastic sole or melt core tells him that there is still too much melt after the screw has frozen off, which leads to an insufficient supply of packing pressure in the part. He solves this problem first by thickening the gating surface. This measure alone has not solved all problems. Based on the information of packing pressure time and melt core, the part is examined for thick spots, and an area that is too thick is replaced by a reinforcement with ribs. This measurement finally results in all traffic lights being green. In summary, the development of the main results from the first to the last attempt are quite significant. Reduction of filling time, pressure requirements, and wall thickness are important economic criteria which result in a reduction of total cycle time by 61%. In addition, there is a general reduction in weight, an increase in quality with regard to process safety, sync marks, voids, and dimensional accuracy. Gate and Go allows companies to monitor, on the one hand side, quality aspects, on the next hand side, you are able to control the production costs. And finally, it could be used as an option to guide the designer and help building skills. For example, if the designer does 5 iterations without success, there could pop up a message like, please contact the specialist department to get a detailed review on your design. Short response times without specialist time, but with specialist know-how. Guided optimization and construction instructions without the need of interpretation skills of simulation results. Gate and Go ideally enables 100% accompanied simulation for the design department to maximize part design, quality, and cost savings. The distribution of these tools in North, South, and Middle America is done by Beaumont, situated in Erie, Pennsylvania. The distribution in Europe, Middle East, Africa, Asia, and the Pacific region is done by MF Software from Germany. All products will be available in January 2021. And MS Software also offers customized solutions. So if you have an idea or special request on an API solution, please don't hesitate to contact us. With that, I'm finished with my presentation and thank you very much for your attention.